Oh my gosh, I don't even want to say this on the internet. She's a bitch, and I still hate her.
My heart dropped. I was like, okay, well, my life is over.
I peed my pants everywhere.
Yeah. Like, you peeked. What's up, you guys? It's Lexi Lombard, and today is going to be a particularly fun video. It's going to be a drunk edition of advice from 20-somethings. I'm here for the holidays in Virginia with some of my favorites. Currently in one of my besties' basement right now. We need to order some food if we're going to be drinking, and Seamless is sponsoring this video, which is super appropriate because they're my favorite food delivery app. I use them all the time in New York City, like probably 2 to 3 times a week, because if you live in New York City, you know how expensive grocery shopping is, and you probably know that takeout food can last you like 2 to 3 meals. If you live in the city and you've never tried it before, definitely use my coupon code.
Click on my link in the description below and use Lexi Lombard for $7 off your first order of $15 or more.
Seamless is available nationwide, but I just use it mostly in the city because a lot of the restaurants have free delivery and they just have a lot of restaurant options. The app is very easy to use. You just go on, you click the restaurant you want, click your menu item, add your tip amount, and then wait for delivery. So we're gonna order a pizza and answer some questions while it's on its way, and let's just get started with the advice from 20-somethings. Drunk edition. Oh, hey. Bouncing around. Nicole, yes, Claire.
Hello.
Claire is the funniest, smartest person I know, swear to God.
What y'all know about this?
The one, the only, Rachel Boone. Kaylee. Kaylee.
It's disgusting.
Kaylee. Shelby and I have been besties for many, many years. Ashley's perfect.
Stop.
This is Ashley Shields, and she's absolutely beautiful. Okay, Rachel and I met for H camp before we ever met in high school. Ninth grade. I believe you posted on my Facebook wall.
That's probably how it happened.
Actually, you know what? I met you at Lauren Schlenker's party for soccer because you, Kaylee, and her had a band.
Honestly, we already made a video on my channel all about our friendship.
Are you talking about Top Shelf?
That's the name of it.
Fourth grade, Lexi comes in with this other girl named Jess, who we were friends with, and they were like the hotties of the group.
We were new students.
The hotties. You're the hotties. Yeah. And I hated them.
Forgot all about
that. You guys were kind of the shit.
Forgot all about that. Miss McCluskey! You were in the room next to us. Something happened where like a medical thing happened.
That was me.
What happened?
That's crazy.
My family loves her. Our first class together was
Earth Science.
I was walking out of the door and my arm got shut in it.
Go to the ER for it.
We were at fourth block, which meant end of the day, which meant that everyone was so tired and such an asshole. And we would fucking leave class in the middle and just walk around and be idiots.
Being goofy is like my favorite thing though.
Yeah,
that's what I pride myself on.
Okay, how old were you when you lost your virginity?
17.
That sounds bad. 15 in 3 months.
I was 15 too. Don't feel very good. What is your current relationship with your first serious boyfriend?
Oh my gosh.
Oh my.
Like real boyfriend? We saw him the other day.
Yeah, I know we did.
We're like friendly. We don't really talk.
Kind of weird.
He's great.
I mean, I think we're on good terms.
We don't really speak.
We hug each other hello.
We don't talk really ever, but we don't like hate each other.
I'm learning a lot about being in a serious relationship for the first time.
Claire's in her first serious relationship.
Yeah, it's very interesting. It's a lot of fun. I will say that first and foremost.
You don't talk about it.
No, he's dating my best friend from like preschool.
He's about to have a kid.
Also the first time in my life that I've had to really learn give and take.
It's funny because with first relationships, you always have connections with people. Like it doesn't matter how long it's been.
And to just like be in love and have a companion
I've never just looked at someone and been like, God damn, you're just so cute. Like, I just want to like hug you all the time.
Okay, did you ever get kicked out of class?
Once.
Yes, I did.
Oh my gosh, I don't even want to say this on the internet.
No.
Good.
I was a goody goody.
It was like band class.
With my mom.
One time I was really disrespectful to a certain teacher.
Most devastating moment of my life. Me and Ryan Kelly.
Nuh-uh.
Her next door neighbor. We were accused of cheating on a Spanish exam in 8th grade.
So your heart dropped.
My heart dropped.
There's this kid I really didn't like. His name is Trey High. And he kept trying to flirt with me, so I got really upset.
Me and Joey Brown were like fucking around, like playing with like, because he played trombone and I played the French. I'm so embarrassed.
You played the French horn?
Stop to do that.
And I ended up stabbing him with a pencil. Not in like a bad way, but like he tried to hit me and it's just in his hand. He was totally fine.
Long story short, I was rude.
Whenever I got threatened for a referral, I was like, my mom's gonna be so mad.
Right, and it was like all of that weighing down on me.
My heart dropped. I was like, okay, well, my life is over.
My teacher got so mad. She was like, that's it. She was like, I'm sick of you guys.
And then she literally freaked out and I had to go to the principal's. But that's about it.
I walked halfway down to the principal's office. No, this is a private interview.
This is Danny.
These are my ladies. I love them so much.
He was,
and I grew up with these ladies.
He did. He was in her homeroom, but always came to mine for some reason.
Like I think there's a lot too.
And they, because you know our homeroom was lit.
In a little.
What is this?
I'm doing a get to know my high school friends video. I was thinking the senior pranks, like.
Oh yeah.
Because
we were involved in that.
Senior pranks came along and we pulled prank after prank after prank. I actually have a video all about the last day of senior year on my channel.
That was so fun.
It starts off with we blocked off the parking lot so no one could park in there. And we
just parked an awning. Yeah,
and we had a barbecue in the parking lot until morning. Yeah, we made like sausage and eggs and all that.
That's right. And that was like the best day ever.
Nicole's in the middle of talking about her fight.
I walked halfway down to the principal's office and I turned around and I came right back. We had a moment. Never forget. And then she said, okay, you really hurt my feelings, but like, we're okay now. And I was like, I'm so sorry. That's not me. That's not really me. I was just putting on that persona.
We tied string throughout the hallways and the stairways. What basically happened is someone would carry like a piece of yarn. The other person would have the ball of yarn and you would just walk around the hallway in between people. And then what it would create are just like lines of yarn.
Yeah. The water balloon fight,
the basketball game.
That was a good one because nobody knew.
All the boys, they got in these canoes.
The middle of the basketball game. Canoes came out and it was just like they were just
chaos. Did you have any teachers that you in particular had a really good relationship or a really bad relationship with?
Like my best subject?
Yeah.
English.
I had a really bad relationship with my earth science teacher.
I was gonna make
you were also a reader, no?
Yeah. I won an Amazon Books like gift card for reading like the second most amount of books.
She hated me because A, I was always late, but B, because Danny was friends with Claire and I and always talked with us. And she totally had a crush on him because she was like one of the young teachers, so like she could still like relate to us, you know?
That's so embarrassing too. No. I really don't tell anybody this stuff.
No, I think reading's hot, low key. Really? High key, actually.
One time we were on a field trip at the river and Danny was like lost. And she's like, does anyone have Danny's number? I need to text him to like find him. And I was trying to suck up. I was like, I do, I can give it to you. So I gave her Danny's number and apparently she would like text him at night and be like, Danny, did you do the homework? Like,
oh my god,
what the fuck? So she sucked, but she was a bitch and I still hate her.
What was your typical school lunch situation?
You know what?
It just depended on the day. Well, I'm broke as shit.
I was a lazy person. Still am.
I always wanted to buy school lunch.
My mom was very good at packing my lunch. And I didn't pack. I wasn't one of those progressive, I'm gonna eat super healthy and bring my lunch.
I wasn't too health conscious
back then,
which is weird.
So like I was always really jealous of the people who would like, my parents would put like hundreds of dollars and they would just like get cookies and stuff.
I would have my lunch packed and everything and I would go into the cafeteria and be like, oh shit, like they are having chicken tenders today. Like they're having
my favorite sandwich away and eat the lunch.
Yes, I gave my sandwich away a lot.
The school lunches were gross. And I ate them anyway.
Sometimes my mom would wake up at like 3 a.m. and make us all lunches. Sometimes not. And sometimes they were just a sandwich. So I would always go in and buy like fries or something like that. But I was always kind of jealous of people who bought lunch every day.
I got the chicken tenders and would dip them in some mashed potatoes. I got the stuffed cheese sticks. Also, Luna bars, I would bring those.
Stromboli?
No.
Also, when my mom made me lunches, I would like, you know, they made us eat in like blocks, and I was always like the last block, so I would be starving. So I would eat like my sandwich in like first period, and I would have no lunch, and I would have to like buy something else.
It was like a riblet sandwich. Hi. They were like barbecue riblets.
Chopped up pig.
Except for I think it was chicken in barbecue sauce. No, I had the full-on lunch. Actually, I was a lunch packer. Who am I kidding?
She was a lunch packer.
And I also was a Vera Bradley lunchbox girl.
I specifically remember your peanut butter.
Best high school field trip.
senior year, the last field trip we had when we went to
the Crockett Park.
Crockett Park, yep.
Okay, best field trip. I instantly think of that DECA field trip.
Field trip in high school? Do we even go on field trips?
And it was somewhere in Virginia, actually, where we
took
that
the picture class where you take
us.
The hayride. 4-H camp.
I'm fifth grade.
Yeah.
I would have to say New York is probably the most memorable.
I liked New York.
I guess New York.
Wow, I was gonna say Massanutten, the senior field trip, when we were at the pool, the water park.
Okay, you're
if
right.
If I find any of these photos, I'll insert these now. But like, flash.
To be honest, like, her and I, weird enough, like, we have connected a lot on field trips.
And we went on the paddle boats and stuff. I remember Lexi and I, it was like the first stop. We did like the whole NBC studio tour, and we were just having a good time. You know, we were shopping in the gift shop. Unbeknownst to us, everyone was outside waiting, and we were just having a good time. We were like, ooh, look at this, look at this. And then like one of the like chaperones comes in and like, okay, there you two are, let's go, we're all waiting.
Always went to a Broadway show.
Oh, never mind, I was gonna say orchestra, but you got kicked out of that.
Yeah, she was not.
For being manipulative.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's a video. Let me get the camera.
Okay, I'm going to Virginia.
Guys, he's a mascot. Beautiful. First time you ever peed your pants in class?
Never in class. You know, that's still yet to come.
Whoosh.
No.
Ooh, I know this one.
Oh, God,
one,
just use your hands
two.
To count.
I've counted, I peed three times. This is so easy. This is so easy. It's because of Kaylee.
I piss my pants a lot. Like I hold my pee a lot, and like people make me laugh very easily.
It's always because of Kaylee. It's so always funny. Because gym class, seventh grade, peed my pants. Why? Because Kaylee's funny.
I'm sure you met Claire earlier. We were in English class in eighth grade, and Nicholster grabbed a table. Like, these cheerleaders walked in. He picked up a table. Threw it maybe halfway across the entire room. I peed everywhere. I'm like known for like doing shit in my pants. Like, that sounds really bad. That could be so many things. That could be kidding. What am I saying right now?
Nick holds you through a table.
Yeah, anyways, back to that story. I had to get someone's sweatshirt and I wrapped it around me. That was the first time I pissed my pants.
This could be my lucky day, all right?
All right, I got it.
Blow it. You had to make a wish.
I did.
Did you? No. What have you learned since high school?
That if you do your hair and your makeup, people don't think that you can do finance. So you like really just surprise people.
Claire's about to be a dentist, right?
I am. Like, how random is that, right?
I am studying media arts and design. I'm majoring in hospitality, management, and business. Studying interactive web design.
I was like, what is the one major I could pick that not only would make my father happy because he's paying for college, but also I would learn something and make money. So I majored in finance and it's paid off.
You're about to go to San Francisco.
Yeah. No, that's the only reason I get to go there is because of this job and because finance got me there, so.
If you're in the Bay Area, hit up Nicole.
Hit me up.
Look, I'm just gonna tell you guys right now, I think it is so cool that dentists have the ability to like improve people's confidence in themselves by simply just improving their ability or their comfort in smiling.
They never expect a woman to be in finance, so.
Like, your parents probably got you braces and your teeth are straight and nice and pretty. Think about all the people in the world that don't have that and how subconscious they are about smiling. And think about being able to have the power to give somebody that confidence. That's freaking awesome.
Hashtag I think that's Operation so, Smile.
Hashtag Operation Smile. Donate to Operation Smile. It's a great organization.
I'll take this angle. Fine, bitch.
Let's just talk like this.
Hi guys, we're talking about high school.
So, if we were to just eliminate the dentist industry completely from the world, what would you be?
Honestly, okay, this is really funny. You guys can't judge me for this. I would 100% learn how to use a gun and go to Africa and assassinate poachers.
So what have I learned from high school? Okay, you suddenly grow up like that and you have a lot of responsibilities.
Poaching is not cool.
You know, there's this pressure on you when you go to college or kind of grow up to, oh, I have to make a lot of new friends now. I have to make new friends. So this kind of goes back to the whole, like, I met my people in high school.
There's such a stigma that if you say that you like high school, it's instantly
college is
synonymous of like you peaked. You know,
right. I'm sorry.
Your life sucks.
These people I enjoy more than half the people I've met in college, and I'm not gonna just throw them away.
I would become an astronaut.
Just surround yourself with people who like add value to your life.
The first real life lesson I learned was how important it is to be introspective.
If you're in high school, there's hope. If somebody makes you laugh but they're not super popular, like, you know, or they're, I don't know, really smart and you have deep conversations with them, like, you
keep hold on to that.
Just don't be afraid to admit who you are. Don't try to be somebody else, you know, like, if you found yourself,
if you have friendships like that, don't give a shit what other people say.
I think we're always learning from ourselves. I think that there are a lot of things in life that it's difficult to do if you aren't already in love with yourself. You don't value yourself.
Okay, look.
No. There is this notion. If high school is terrible for you, if you absolutely hate high school makes up this much of your entire life. So after high school is over, you can fly as a bird, go wherever you want. However, if you're in high school right now and you're loving it, if the friends you make are friends that you see yourself being with for life, that's fantastic. Think of it as a blessing. Just because you enjoy high school right now does not mean that that is equivalent to you peaking in life. You can enjoy high school without it being the pivotal moment of your existence.
I see it all the time on like on social media. People will say, oh, you liked high school? You're still hanging out with your high school friends? Well, that's when you
peaked. Oh my gosh, like I've never connected with somebody like this. So found you people in high school. That's okay. You know, you find people, you meet new people.
There's no shame in that.
Favorite quote from Shia, you might have seen it on Twitter. I know I did. she said, you know, my mom told me when I was young that I am gonna grow up and marry a rich man. And then she says, Mom, I am a rich man.
Your life can be great every step of the way for all I care. Don't let your enjoyment of high school make you scared for the future, okay?
High five.
Kitty out.
Don't be scared.
Also, can we acknowledge that Kaylee is drinking this much?
And sorry, the whole time we've been talking about this, I've been staring at this photo of my grandparents.
I'm tired.
She did great. She did super good. She did super good. I don't know why she doesn't think so. It was great meeting you guys. Don't know if you're gonna see me in this video, but great to meet you.
Subscribe to the channel.
Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun to film, and I hope you love my friends as much as I do. And I will see you in my next video. I love you guys. Bye.
Love you.
Game.
Bingo, bingo. You mean innuendo?